Good morning to you, everyone. It is very nice to be here to make the some discussion on the skill development within the curriculum. Before getting into a small introduction, I want to make myself. I am Dr. Nabi, Director of InfoPlus Technology. Very specific information I can share it with you is I stand before you with a very unique mixture of experience, academician for 10 years, and one of the top technocrat in Wipro technology for about 10 years. Came out of it and innovated some of the learning methodology for the skill development. That's what I am going to discuss with you. See, in a very generic way, our curriculum has delivered the wonderful students for decades. If you take our the top 20% of the student population, which has gone abroad, have done the lot of work, and the whole IT innovation all has happened because of that 20% which has performed out of their boundaries. But what has happened is, in the 80s and 90s, that 20% was the 100%. So because all those 100% students came from IITs or Government Engineering College and the NITs, the performance have been outstanding. That's why the name and the fame what the, our country has because of that population. Then what has happened is that IT boom has taken a lot of these people into their own system, and we got into a scalability because of the IT requirements. Because of IT requirements, we have done the large scalability in the technical education sector particularly. Then what it has became is that the 20% is the top layer and the 80% is the what the other one. That 80% we have left it unattended for lot two decades. Why it is that 80% most of them able to get placement in the IT companies. That is the truth, ground level truth of the what has happened. So we have left the 80% unattended. Then when the core engineering companies and the manufacturing sector started expanding in the country last 10 years, everybody is crying. Student is crying, I am not getting the good teacher. The teacher is getting, I am not getting the good job. And the college management is driving through the ranking. And of course, the university also driving to the ranking. But what we have totally forgotten is that our unit of learning is the classroom. We have left that classroom unattended for maybe nearly 2 years in the technical education sector particularly. So that's what it will happen. Before getting to the other point, I really want to thank Dr. Sandeep to put the point which are, we have been driving it in through our business in number of time. That is free flow credit system, branchless BE, and it is better to uncover something in the syllabus or the curriculum. What is the meaning of, I can explain the branchless BE. I am the one of the core guy where we delivered or exported Nokia phone as a phone to the Nokia when they were very popular. We had a software system, hardware system, and the mechanical. I am total in charge for the mechanical, but we have a full understanding of what will happen in the software side, what will happen the hardware side. The learning of that one is that a mechanical engineer within the boundary, within his compartment, if he stick to it, the skill development never going to happen. Because of the technological changes which has happened. So a student is expected to know whether it is as a product level learning rather than the branch-wise learning. We should do a electromechanical product. We should do the heavy industry products. So we should have a degree in a product level or a domain level minimum, not on the types of branches what we have been having for the last so many years. Coming to the skill development within the curriculum. See, the government policies from the state or the center, what they are looking at is that the skill development is something after BE, after ITI, after polytechnic. If I make the one quote which I make every engineering college, because take it from me, last 5 years, I have traveled around 576 engineering colleges of the country, from the down south to the up to the Punjab and Haryana. Even eastern parts and western parts, I go there to make the new innovative product what we have been working on it. So what has happened to that and the skill development, everyone looking at, after BE, anyone go through a 3 months course, what government is offering, skill development happens. Never. The skill development need to happen from the first hour of my BE course or a BTech course, not on the last few weeks of BE degree where I am sitting for the campus interview. That's where this one is coming. The another point which I want to make it here by from the personal experience is that the uncovering the syllabus is the very important point in the curriculum to motivate the students. I am a graduate of 83-86 from Madras Institute of Technology, Chennai, and former professor, vice chancellor, Dr. Sadiq was my professor at that time. He always take the class, and he took us 4 or 5 subjects for us. He never covered more than the 40%. During the one interactive session, couple of students we put across to him, why you never complete the 100% syllabus in your thing? What he was always telling us, if I taught you 40% right, or better understanding I have given 40%, I am sure you will take the 60% on your own. If institutes or the university need to motivate the students on a self-learning, it is better to a better teaching of 40%, leave it to him to learn rest of the things. So that's how the different things will go. Just I will get into what is the innovative product we do on that one. We innovated this product called learning for a 3D-based visual system for the technical education, complete technical education. Started in 2009, more or less 9 years we have worked. 9 years we have worked, and these 9 years we have developed complete visual 3D visual for the technical education, whether it is a graduate engineering or a polytechnic or a ITI, we deliver this system as per the respective curriculum. Because until you give the definition of the curriculum, the award of degree never going to get defined. So there need some definition of a curriculum. That curriculum, we take it as a prime delivery to a specific university. And what I mean by 3D way of learning is that, because, see, if you take a 1 hour classroom, it's, let's say, 60 minutes. What we are proposing is that, or we have been implemented in a lot of places, is that, let's the lecture do the, or a professor do the lecturing for 40 minutes. That 40 minutes content, we deliver as a 4 minutes 3D visual to capture the essence of what he taught. Because it's well known is that hearing is one type of learning, but definitely the retention of the content by the students will happen wonderfully if we were demonstrating using 3D models on the other way. Across the product, we develop even for a fundamental law, derivations, or all other things, we will show it like a simple 3D visual to explain the content. Apart from that, we also currently working on a virtual lab with a 3D interactive system. When I say virtual lab, every experiment of a laboratory, we will give it in a 3D model workbench where student can interact and take the reading, do the performance curve. That is what this image was explaining. That is, he changes the rotation, number of rotation. He measures the volt or current. He enters into the table. He sees the better performance. This will be an opportunity to do the design parameterization of the this one. Like this 3D model, we have already developed 100,000 3D models to explain the complete curriculum of the technical education. We have complete product for the all the most of the popular 10 popular branches in the polytechnic, 20 ITI trades, and first 2 to 3 years of the BE degree course, we have lost. It took us 10 years to develop to this level. So what we do in the, if you take ITI, we have, as per NCVT syllabus, we do the theoretical portion, we do the practical portion, we do the online assessment. We only provide the content, and the professors or the lecturers can use it there. In a very simple way, if I need to put it across, if you take a BA degree, it is consist of 1,400 to 1,500 lecture hours. This 1,400 to 500 lecture hours, we have proven for last 10 years that we can deliver 100 hours of a visual which will give the complete essence of this 1,500 hours lecture hours, which will be done in within 100 hours of the 3D visual. The second part is there will be 24 laboratories for as a subject for a BE degree, which will consist of 275 experiments, which can be given as a every model 3D model base to explain this. Okay, so that's what I will do only 2 minutes of my product, simple product demo. By that, I will finish it out. This is just a sample of the product. I am doing it there. I am just taking the one simple example. So this will be all the content will be organized as per the syllabus. Let's say construction of a DC motor is the syllabus given. So the professor want to explain the text for 40 minutes. He will explain all this content. He will explain all this content in a oral form or write this many things, because these writings are not copy of any ebook or internet. My renowned professor who has got retired from this system, we captured and brought their knowledge into this digital system. So this, whatever written in the text form, will be explained using a three-dimensional demonstration like this. So this demonstration will be of a one-minute nature.
An exploded view of a small DC machine.
So this will completely explain a 3D way of presenting what he taught on that particular class. Not before the class, not after the class. That, let's say, if I am 27th hour of the syllabus or a lesson planning, this is on the 27th hour. 26th hours, you will have different. 28th hour, it will have different. This will go for a one-minute video, the demonstration like this, completely talking about what you taught for 40 minutes, captured in a 1 minute to 1.5 minutes. For a single one-hour lecture, that is 60 minutes lecture, we deliver 3 to 4 3D demonstration like this, which will give the complete essence of this. That's what I am saying is, if you take the DC motor construction, you can see there are 16 demonstration which is equivalent to the 5-hour lesson planning of the syllabus curriculum described in most of our universities. Maybe 90% of universities do like that only. So the other part, when some of the discussion came, what is an engineer supposed to do? He is expected to solve a problem. He is not expected to do anything beyond that. To solving problem, what we do in this one is that, for example, I'm just taking one problem. Tutorial class is one of the very important class of work for the industry expectation, because industry expects he should have a knowledge qualitatively in terms of when his 5 meter is told, he should be very clear qualitatively. In a typical classroom, what we are doing it, we go to the tutorial class, professor will dictate a problem, then he will give some of the parameter explanation to that one. That parameter explanation, use this formula, get this value. We never quantify or qualify that statement. That's why it became very, very necessary to give a physical meaning to the problem what we taught in the classroom. That's what we try to do here. If it's a 3D problem, we give a 3D particular product and show them what is this current is all about, where you measure your voltage. What is the performance criteria of this product? That's a learning it will happen. Now what will happen is complete analogy is in his mind. He would have forgot all the text, what the lecture what he has took. And the what he is caring is what industry expecting in a very, very physical form. That's what the skill development. Because we develop as per the curriculum for a subject of 45 hours. We deliver 200 3D demonstration like this to explain 45 hours of a lecture content into a 200 3D demonstration like this. Maybe I will end it with the last one comparison, how these things are differ from the what is existing in the currently. Because, see, there are only two ways of learning things, or what a classroom learning. I will put it in a classroom learning, up to my knowledge, traveled across the world, across the universities, particularly across the country I have traveled. There are only two things we have in this world. One is Indian way of learning things, another one is developed Western countries' way of learning things. These are only two things. The difference between these two is very, very basic. What in our classroom, same motor, you take it, I am getting into the class, I will write on the board, Faraday's law of this. So I will explain the law, do the derivation, do the problem. While going out of the class, the lecturer will tell the students, hey, this principle is applied in electrical motors, so tomorrow come with some assignment on electrical motors, he goes away. What is Western developed countries have been doing it for decades is, same construction motor of a DC generator, a professor come to a classroom with a small piece of a motor or something, a prototype, something, he will bring it to the class. He will explain complete motor in the classroom, talk about 60 minutes about the motor. Towards the end, when he goes out, he will say, this motor, do the Faraday's law in this application. Tomorrow assignment is on Faraday's law. Where? That's where we are strong on fundamental. We have been ruling on the design side across the countries because our fundamentals are so strong. If our fundamentals are so strong with the application knowledge, I think we will be a country which cannot be beaten by anyone. Thank you very much.